So I get a lot of queries, and the game changer vegan diet is blasting through the universe right now. Two questions I want to answer. Why should you select a vegan diet? And why should you not select a vegan diet? Now, I'm a guy who sits on the fence because I believe in the qua of a person. Qua means incapacity, so you have to discover your capacity. So let me tell you why a vegan diet works. A vegan diet works because I worked with Sushil Kumar, and he's vegetarian. Well, he used to have animal products, which was milk. But in veganism, you don't have dairy products, or you don't have eggs. You don't have things like honey. So in a vegan diet, I have seen, compared to a non-veg diet, I'm seeing lesser inclination towards inflammation. So ESR, C-reactive protein. I've seen lower homocysteine levels. I've seen better cholesterol levels. So in the overall gamut, since I work with athletes, I found out that because these inflammation markers are lower, recovery is faster. With people with food allergies, when I've tried to heal their gut, if I've chosen predominantly a vegetarian or a vegan diet, because milk I know increases mucus production, it does some kujali inside your body. So when you have this, there is a faster removal, or you know, set back to a good condition where you're not allergic to too many things. So veganism has a huge indications in terms of positive recovery in athletes. And more than anything else, I think it's a concept that we have been educated, including me, when we've studied in medical college, when we've done nutrition and certification, we've been told, keep looking at protein, keep looking at protein. Yes, you have to look at protein. But I think there is also this viewpoint that for very, very, very long, animal protein creates powerful athletes. Sushil Kumar is a classic example of where non-veg has never touched the body and they've gone in that direction. Now, why should you not do veganism? I believe you should not do veganism. You should attempt to try it, but have your heart rate monitored, have your VO2 max, which is your breathing capacity, monitored, have your C-reactive protein, your ESR monitored, have your vitamin and mineral levels monitored. So you start at day zero, go vegan, and then go for 90 days. I am sure people will have bad results also, because we are all unique. So when you have a bad result, things like vitamin B12 could go down. Things like your protein content could not be carefully managed. If you're not under the advice of a good nutritionist, you could have a lesser shortfall. Why? Because in the vegan food, you tend to eat a lot of plant-based material, and the percentage of protein is very lower in the plant-based. So to get the daily quantity of more protein, 1-2 grams per kg body weight, the quantity of food that needs to be consumed in veganism is much more. Now, the issue over here is nobody's talking about this on the internet. Gastric distress. When you eat a lot of food, you know, if you have a washing machine which is designed for 3 kgs, okay, and you put in 10 kgs of clothes, after some time the washing machine is going to have some bearing problems and belt problems and spinning problems and all. Similarly, if you put too much of food into you suddenly, which is the veganism concept, you have to eat more calories as an athlete. If you're an arm army, there's no problem, because you know your match to match calories is okay, and you know, even up to 0.8 grams per kg body weight, people manage on a regular basis. So it's only the athletes who require a higher protein diet. So if you're an athlete watching this, you need to test and check what is your protein, you need to test and check what is your calorie, you need to test and check what are your inflammation markers, and then proceed with the vegan diet. So you start at day zero, and then 90 days later, you check again all of these variables. By the way, the clearest indication for me that a vegan diet may not work is your heart rate in the morning. So be off a vegan diet, check your heart rate every morning for 30 days, average it out. What's your resting heart rate as soon as you get up? Then go vegan and check what's your resting heart rate. If your heart rate is lower, it's a clear indication that it's a better diet for you. Vegan or not vegan, you need a nutritionist to help you go forward. $1 million question, have I gone the vegan way? I've definitely reduced my non-veg, but I love my eggs. I'm allergic to eggs, but I cheat. Like every human being out there, the taste buds are more powerful than the gut. So a moment on the lip, forever to your hips. Remember this, get in touch with us at quanutrition, and let's see if we can help customize a customizable vegan diet for you with monitoring, whether it's good, bad, or ugly for you.